JANKYnik's ModPack Voltz recently updated to version 3.1, now with 190 mods and infinite warfare possibilities. Enter the Voltz one-on-one battlefield. Two compounds, 57 blocks apart, diamond blocks embedded in each. I, JANKYnik, are playing Janky Kev. 500 diamond blocks are embedded in total in each compound, some vulnerable, some protected by obsidian. The objective? To destroy as many as possible on the enemy compounds in 1.5 hours. One can cross sides, but not without warning the opposition. Multiple sources of infinite power and abundant resources are provided, but how each side will use these will vary. Who will come out on top? Find out soon in the Voltz one-on-one war. So, these are the rules. Hello, Kev. How are you doing?
Hello, Nick. Hi.
And we are on the battlefield right now. Battlefield. This is it.
This is a battlefield front line.
Hardline.
Right here.
Hardline. I think you mean.
Hardline. This is one hardline we're on right now, Nick.
It is.
It's the division between my base over here, which is the blue version of you, just like blue.
The statues didn't fare too well. there's mine. So, let me show you around, Kev. Just wanna come down here.
All right. Yep. Ooh.
So, this is the battlefield, and the objective is there's a 30-minute non-PvP truce period, and then after that a 1-hour PvP war period, and we're on two separate compounds. And if you fly up here, Kev, you'll notice all of these diamond blocks.
Yeah.
Now, what I do is if I just do that, and what I can do is we've got world edit on here. So if I do my first position there, and I right click on my second position here, can you see the world edit stuff going on?
No, I don't.
Well, what happens is, if I type in /count57, which is the item ID for diamond blocks, it will tell me that, count 57, there we go. It'll say counted 500. So there are exactly 500 diamond blocks on each base. And the objective is in the 1.5 hours, to destroy as many diamond blocks on the other team's base as you can.
Holy shit.
And you'll notice that a lot of diamond blocks are kind of bare in plain view, unprotected.
Yeah.
But underneath, if you look at the top of the base that you're next to now, under the obsidian roof is more diamond blocks. So there's a lot of diamond blocks that are actually protected by obsidian as well, which is pretty resistive material.
Yeah. I think the only way to, break through that is, nukes and shit.
You're going to need some specialized explosives and missiles to get through that. And over here, you've got stairs to get up to the top, because, of course, if you make a rocket launcher, you'd want to put it on the top here.
And I feel like once the diamond blocks have been broken from your base, you can't replace them. I think that's just cheating.
Yeah, you can't.
So once they're broken, they're broken. Can you use them? Like, if you picked one up that was broken,
One of the rules is you cannot pick up any diamond blocks. You can't mine them. You can't move them. They have to stay in place. If they get destroyed, you can't pick them up. If you come down into the room, there you are. You'll notice there's a lot of supplies, especially if you have a look in this golden chest here. There is a lot of supplies in here for you. There's pretty much more than you can imagine. Because the way I built this map, there are no models underneath us. So I basically, there's about 5 stacks of every ore you could want underneath this. In this chest. Yeah.
Wiki.com.
Because we're on Voltz 3.1.0, which is, the old Voltz was like 42 mods. This is 119.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of mods. So there's a lot of stuff to do. If you want to. We've also got an MFSU fully charged, and also a resonant energy cell fully charged.
Is this red power or some shit?
This is thermal expansion, the resonant energy cell. Industrial craft one, the MFSU, that can be used to power most things like rocket launchers, ICBM stuff. And the thermal expansion stuff is just for thermal expansion and all redstone flux compatible mods. You've also got 128 buckets of lava stored in these tanks here.
Oh, wow.
And one more thing is, if you just come outside for a second, one of the other rules is a player is not allowed at all to go past these walls, the surrounding walls. You can destroy the walls, but underneath, 2 blocks underneath me here, is bedrock. So there's like a bedrock surround in the ground, and you are not allowed to go over that if these walls here are destroyed. They're made of triple compressed cobblestone, which is pretty good, pretty blast resistant, but it's not completely blast resistant.
So are you saying that we're not allowed to, like... So the only way to get rid of your diamond blocks is ranged?
Yes. It's ranged, or what you can do is you can go right up to these walls, put an explosive here, and try and do as much damage as you can.
Okay, so we can leave our base.
You can leave your base, yeah. You can absolutely leave your base.
But I can't go into your base.
You can't go into my compound. You can't go past this point.
Okay.
Even if these walls don't exist, you still wouldn't be allowed to go past this point here.
Okay, that's fair enough.
And the next thing is, if I... come over here. Now, if you notice, the one of the other rules is to go, if you want to go to the other side of this wall, you have to go through these double doors.
Yeah.
And they're alarmed. Oh. So that means the other player is warned that someone's coming
over. They're
very loud,
too.
Yeah, they are.
I wonder if I can hear them. Do you want to...
You can do. And if you go in there and you go inside your compound, just look in the direction of the gold chest. If I stand on these, you get flashing lights as well.
Wow, that's nice. That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
So if you go and stand on them, and I'll show everyone here as well, and what happens, you just have to stand on any
Very
of the...
loud, too.
Yeah, it
you
is pretty loud.
Can hear it miles away.
What you have to do is you have to turn your game sound down. Yeah, you can see there that these start flashing when you stand on those pressure plates.
Yeah. That's awesome.
And yeah, I think that's as much as I can think of. So what we'll do is after the 30-minute truce period and the one-hour fight period, I will do another world edit count to see how many diamond blocks are left on each side. And if before the completion of the 1.5 hours, if you think you've destroyed all of the diamond blocks on the other side, we'll do a world edit count. And if you destroy all of the diamond blocks on the other side before the time period's over, you win automatically.
Yeah. Oh,
but you do have to do a lot to get rid of
all of them.
All of them, yeah. It's going to be quite a challenge. So yes, those are the rules. At least all the rules I can think of on the top of my head. If I remember any more, I'll let you know. And also I'll say in the videos themselves. So best of luck, Kev, and hope you don't get obliterated well.
Oh,
I
mean,
I kind of do hope you do get obliterated, but...
Wait, what?
I mean, beginner's luck,
eh? But Nick... Oh, yeah, by the way, Nick, I don't know my ass from my face when it comes to Voltz anymore.
Well, we did Big Dig last year, so, I mean, you can...
Last year. I haven't played Minecraft since then, but, you know...
Well, NEI is your friend. Just type something in. Click and then press R on stuff. You've seen ICBM before, Kev, because ICBM is like the king mod of Voltz and of this.
So that's what we have to use. Whereas, can we do some like peace treaty? No, is that out of the question?
30 minutes peace treaty.
No, I mean like a permanent one, so we don't have to blow each other up.
Right? Yeah, I'm not sure that's on the table, to be honest, Kev.
Oh, shit. All right, Nick.
But yeah, good luck.
All right, get out of here, you big bastard. You son of a bitch.
Okay.
You fucking ass wipe.
All right.
I'm gonna blow you to smithereens, you gob nobbler.
All right.
Dude, what? Okay. I'm sorry. I love you.